Now, the comrade that will speak next is Anrekan Konjali from Turkey, from the CEP in Turkey.
Thank you, comrade. Greetings from revolutionaries in Turkey to all comrades. Today, we came together as revolutionary Marxist youth from all around the world. To start with, I greet all comrades boldly, raising the voice of the oppressed and exploited against the capitalism. Our, the revolutionary socialist, struggle is gaining more and more importance day by day in the face of the failures of capitalism. In an international struggle, it is very important to share the experiences of the revolutionary struggles in every country and to move forward with the accumulation of these experiences. For this very reason, I will start sharing with you the atmosphere in Turkey where we raised the revolutionary Marxist struggle, comrades. As you may know, there has been AKP regime and Tayyip Erdoğan's dictatorship lasting for 20 years in Turkey. Erdoğan's dictatorship continues his war and exploitation politics throughout the country. Of course, these are not different from the bourgeois politics in the rest of the world. For instance, in the pandemic process, we have witnessed the collapse of the health system privatized by neoliberal politics. Similar to the rest of the world, although tens of thousands of workers lost their job, that the Erdoğan government put its all effort to keep factories and touristic places open and workers working for the sake of Boğaz's profit amid pandemic. This means living on the verge of death. Turkey is a country where conflicts are very clear. The war discourse made regularly by the government, police state implementations, and burdening the price of the crisis to the people create a huge energy against the dictatorial regime ruling for years in Turkey. However, this energy has not turned into an actual popular uprising yet. Of course, in order for this energy to turn into a successful movement, as we have experienced from history, revolutionary subjects must gain power. The agenda of the struggle against failures of capitalism is always alive here. To illustrate, we carried out many important resistance in Turkey last year. For example, the movement and actions against femicides and the judicial system of the government that protects the murderers. Another important dynamic was the workers who give struggle against slavery conditions and systematic death in the workplaces because of the greed of the capitalists. Thirdly, the youth gave important reactions, organized boycotts against anti-democratic attacks and fascist threat. And last but not least, the struggle given against the ecological destruction that became a big national campaign to protect the forest against mine projects. Besides all these struggles, we have to talk about Kurdish people and their struggle. Erdoğan's dictatorship continues his racist, capitalist policies on the Kurdish people. This is how he divides the working class and rule the country. Under Erdoğan's regime, already weak democratic rights in the general and the gained rights of Kurdish people are actually taken away. The Kurdish people who is oppressed and killed has been seeking a salvation for decades. The polarization policies of the government create a chauvinistic atmosphere towards them. The government also pursues similar discourse towards Syrian immigrants. We, the young revolutionaries, always stand by the rightful struggle of the Kurdish people and their right to self-determination. We struggle against the oppressors and exploiters. The youth has an active role in the struggle in Turkey. Problems faced by the young, such as unemployment, futurelessness, and despair, raise great anger within them. The struggle of the youth actively continues on the streets about issues such as democratic rights, economic crisis, political pressures, and war politics. We live in a country where one in every four young is unemployed, just like the tendency around the world. The youth cannot see a future here. The conditions of the system expose us harder problems than ever before. But the main thing here is to transform this potential and massive energy into a concrete struggle. That is exactly what we are trying to do in Turkey. young masses who can easily slide under the influence of the bourgeois opposition figures have been betrayed by the opposition for many years. This opposition standpoint, which relies on the elections and embraces discourse of power, has nothing to give the youth. On the other hand, life requires intervention at any moment. It is necessary to organize this dynamic, to broaden transformative revolutionary ideas every day with concrete actions and gain rights with class-centric struggle. Here, we need the lessons of the 68 movement for a worldwide salvation. In the atmosphere of the 68 movement, the actions around the world were not independent from each other. There was a common goal and soul. There were common discourses, anti-war, freedom, and equality. At the present time, of course, very strong and interrelated actions are being organized around the world. The slogan that the youth of the world should chant must be not enough. Actions are taking place, but not enough to change. That is why it is important to establish ISL, which is a younger unity and covers different combinations on struggle. It is a must to strengthen ISL to fight against capitalism worldwide with a joint organization and a common force. Therefore, we should not be content with what we have and what we should feel a great responsibility on our shoulders. We know that in the 21st century, Marxism is still relevant. While the exploitation accelerates, class conflicts are getting sharper. Marx's ideas are always instructive and guiding in understanding real life. Yet, what is important here is to have to build a new world with his ideas. As Marx said, just knowing and understanding is never enough. It is necessary to create vanguard subjects and raise the hope for the masses. Last year, we had witnessed spreading rise mass movement in which the youth is active, keep going on taking place all over the world. Even if they start at different times with different reasons, this wave is frightening the capitalists of the world, basically emphasize a common slogan. We do not want to live under this system. The reason for these actions is mostly an economic crisis laying the burden on the exploited, and sometimes spontaneous actions grow rapidly. These rise once again prove us that the energy of mass actions will spread rapidly. We are talking about the fact that COVID-19 sparked this dynamic once again. The pandemic led the governments to be more authoritative and impose more austerity policies. These policies caused millions of people faced with unemployment all around the globe. This crisis atmosphere of capitalist system manifests itself everywhere. Far-right governments make these conditions even worse for the youth. Under these conditions, the youth are looking for an out. To illustrate, 270 million of the young people around the world are neither studying nor working. The capitalists just play with our future. Despair is our the biggest enemy of the youth and the masses. Besides optimism being realistic, vital too. We need to become hopeful with the spark of the political atmosphere that created by the masses pouring into streets. But we also need to know that is not enough. Thus, we have to see an anti-capitalist revolution revolt around the world. If there happen to be a reason to live, it is the reality that we can and we will change this world, comrades. This is the only alternative. If not, there is no way forward for humanity. Thank you.